Junk food binging. Statistics show the average American per year takes down 53 gallons of soda, 29 pounds of French fries, 23 pounds of pizza, that's my problem, and 150 pounds of sugars or other sweeteners. So how do we break the habit? Certified clinical nutritionist Dr. Robert Silverman joins us live in the studio. Thanks for joining us.
Great to be here. Thanks for having me.
How do I break the habit?
Breaking the habit is great. You know, I understand that you're going to have that junk food binge, that sugar binge. Sugar is a toxin over the weekend, but Monday morning, I got a great four-part plan. Number one, I want you to recognize and reboot in the morning. Understand that, you know, that you made a mistake and you want to reboot it. Take some unsweetened almond butter. Great choice. Got a lot of good fats. Going to decrease that sugar that you've consumed over the weekend and in the morning with those hot lattes that everybody likes to drink. Number two, I'm a big proponent of planning ahead for your breakfast. Your Monday morning breakfast should be avocado egg toast. Now, I like the toast gluten-free, just like we have right there. Gluten-free bread is the way to go. Avocados are fabulous. They're a fruit. They have great fats. They also have oils that help with digestion. The fat is going to decrease the sugar. Avocado egg toast, put a little egg on top, just like I have there, free-range egg, a great breakfast.
The hard-boiled egg?
Hard-boiled egg is great. You can cook it if you'd like. I don't want you to fry.
Not a lot of oils or fried.
Not a lot of oil and fried. Absolutely not. Number three, the lychee nuts, they're the lychee nut or lychee polyphenols, they're great. Now, the problem with that fruit, although it's pretty accessible here in New York, it's not accessible in other areas, that lychee polyphenol problem is that the fruit has got a lot of sugar.
It's my favorite fruit.
I'm sure it is. It's sweet as anything. It's about 29 grams of sugar per cup. So I recommend oligonol, which is a very well-researched lychee polyphenol that you can get in a supplemental form without the sugar. Research is in on it, and guess what it says? It decreases blood sugar, helps you with insulin, and it helps you right over here with those little love handles that we're afraid to have. And it helps with what we call visceral fat, that fat on the inside. And finally, last but not certainly not least, you got some prebiotic foods that you can load up on. Those prebiotics like garlic, onion, and the like, you know why they're so good? They feed your gut. They feed those probiotics that I have right there. And guess what else? Those prebiotics enable you to bring that blood sugar down.
The almond butter, back to the first step.
Mm-hmm. Tastes good.
With a teaspoon, a tablespoon, or on some toast?
Go for it. Tea or tablespoon. A nice tablespoon of almond butter is fabulous. Make sure it's unsweetened. Almond butter is great. Avoid the peanut butter.
All right. Your book, Inside Out Health. What's the gist of the book?
The gist of the book is to fix the body from the inside. Everybody's looking at the outside. You really want to look at the body from the inside and understand that we have to treat the systems of the body and not just the symptoms. And one of the biggest things that you want to look at and you want to fix inside the body is gut health.
All right.
And that's why we got those probiotics.
I think we got 30 seconds, so we're going to focus on me and my problem.
Great topic.
The morning show. All I want to do is have a pound cake and a cup of coffee every morning.
I hear you.
So what do I do?
Avocado egg toast. You got to go right across the street and have it. Come on. Oh, and or once again, if you're going to do it.
I got to make it at home. It's like 4 in the morning.
Call me and I'll deliver it for you.
Fair enough. Thank you very much, Dr. Silverman, for joining us.
My pleasure for being here.
Okay. That's all for New York One News Live at 8. Stay with us for the latest on your top stories and your weather on the ones. We also have In the Papers coming up at 8:42.